location then is Maibo in the Moyen Chai region of southern Chad. If you all look at your maps now, you'll see that there's a red border all the way around the green area, yeah? That's the boundary, okay? You've got contour lines on there, you've got spot heights on there. On the maps I've just given you as well, there are spot codes. And they're used for quick reference, especially for the vehicles. So you've got red route, which goes red 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. You've got black route, which goes 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. And then you've got blue, which goes 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Does everyone see those?
Yeah.
Yeah? Anyone not see the spot codes? There's one more thing marked on the map. If you guys look up where there's red 3 and red 4, everyone see that? Yeah? You'll see a red dotted line that runs parallel with a track. Yeah? Along the outside of the track. That's the Chad, Central African Republic border. We're right now in the CAR. Chad is north, okay? So north side of the border, Chad, south side of the border is Car. Yeah? Everyone got that?
Yeah.
Cool. Following an attempted coup in the Central African Republic, the Azerian State terrorist group are now attempting to exploit the power vacuum created by the death of the Salika leader, Banjo Tosin. What a name. Tosin was killed during Task Force 29 operation to recover the president of the Central African Republic and was later recovered and moved to a safe location. Fighting continues for control of the capital. SIGINT has confirmed large-scale mobilization of Azerian state forces. Satellite imagery has shown that multiple vehicles, including troop transporters, are all moving towards the Central African Republic border, and we know where that is. Special Operation Task Force Chad, which is us, have been deployed onto the border in the vicinity of Maibo, which is one of the several suspected border crossing points being used by Azerian state fighters. From here, we will conduct mobility operations and security operations to prevent Azerian state crossing over into the Central African Republic. Okay, our mission then, main effort is to deny Azerian state forces the use of the Maibo border crossing and reduce enemy force operations. I'll say that again. Deny Azerian state forces use of the Maibo border crossing and reduce enemy force operations. Our objectives then are to disrupt Azerian state supply runs, secure the Maibo border crossing, seize Azerian state shipments, and eliminate Azerian state HVIs. Okay, so actions on then, contact or compromise depend on what your tasking is. Obviously, if you're any of the six call signs to begin with, your actions on contact should really be defensive. Just try and find another route round and sneak through with your primary role being recce to begin with. Essentially what you guys are going to be doing, we'll get to it in a bit because we'll break down into two parts, we'll be trying to identify the actual points along the border that they're using to cross things over, okay?
Right, Nick, when you're ready.
Are you taping this up?
What? No, I'm just going to cinch it.
Yeah, that was me keying the other one. I don't have to do anything fancy with this, do I?
Hey, one shot, one kill. What a cut.
Yeah.
Wagon one's up.
there now, mate, and we check some other routes off. All right, we'll do that.
If we stay here, even like when we go down to the country, we're giving away 5 grand.
Yeah, yeah.
Aren't we?
Yeah.
The inside of it, really. What's for rent?
We'll drop down where we originally said, and then work different routes on the track from there. Check and then get the SATCOM up, mate.
Yeah, no, I mean, do you want it back a bit off the road? Do you want it?
I tuck it into it, blocks this kind of. I mean, the idea is that they get drawn to the vehicles and then we're in there and fucking mallet them.
Okay. Right. Nick, yeah. Wherever you want to stick the vehicle, then, mate.
Yeah. Wait, you want it in the brush somewhere? It doesn't have to be covered, mate. Just
yeah, but just sort of up and in those trees.
I'll just stick it back here where my squad is. Cool. Or even just like here. Just here.
Like, okay, so you want it actually seen and draw them in?
Well, we can't hide it, mate. No. Those are going to be the two higher areas like that. Okay, so that's that berm just there.
Yes.
Okay, so we're going to have one just behind that, one the other side of the track, one down in there, and then another triangle in here.
Yeah.
All right, and then the vehicles are all in there.
Yeah.
All right?
Yeah.
Tree, about 5 meters behind the pine tree. got hold in there. They are coming. Okay.
Sounds pretty heavy, like.
Ben, what's the plan, buddy? One guy straight ahead on the other side of the two that are dead.
What's your opinion on this, mate? Do you reckon you can wipe them out, or is this going to start stagnating?
We can definitely hold them here, but pushing them back, I don't know.
Yeah, receive, Ben, receive. All right, mate, just keep on it for now, mate. I'll try and get some reinforcements to you.
You're in, dead, mate.
BHR,
yeah,
we'll say, look, yeah,
don't know.
Okay, so we'll say BHR. Right, those the forces we have, it's probably the forces we have.
Both, there's another two teams en route, but we don't know how far away they are yet.
Right, so we have three teams operating here at this moment. Yep.
This road's hot still, yeah?
Yeah.
I don't know about this undergrowth.
Right, okay. Right,
so I've pushed three corgis down there. It's me, you and James. I don't know where anyone else is at the minute.
We've got Steve just in front of us here. He's just been telling me he's heard movement on this right side of the road to our left.
Yeah, so what, down there?
Just don't take any necessary risk, mate, because they've got to come up to us. They've sneaked up a couple of times, so you do need to keep an eye out. This area here seems to be they can get quite close before they can start firing. Yeah.
Guys! Kev! What have we got? You dead? It's gone through! It's gone straight down, not debussed anybody!
At least four bodies in the rear. That's all I can see, but straight
across. Yeah.
I got knocked in the woods.
Okay, it's gone down!
Right, situation is, we've had the Dutch on the right hand side who've been taken out, been re-medicked, and they're now going back down into that position. We've got one guy, Wonski, on the front of the vehicle to cover for the rear attack.
Yeah.
I've got James on the left side here. Obviously, I have Dunk in the middle, just midway down the hill.
Roger that.
I have no idea what's going on at the bottom of the hill and into the woods.
At the moment, the vehicles are still stationary parked. We We just had that other time vehicle.
That's
come
a test
forward.
Vehicle, mate. He's counted numbers.
Say again, mate.
They've counted numbers as they come through there.
So. Hey, the watch to the rear.
We've got your person in this red chit-rich here. Yeah, like a whole lot of them.
They didn't fancy anything.
Actually, done. A bit further this way. I don't want them to use that tractor as cover if they have to do bus.
Kev, Mark.
They've got open ground then to have to
get. Where do you want?
Mark, send over.
Stay around, here.
You looking on 6, over.
In here?
Yeah, looking all quiet. What numbers have you got round there?
I have two guys forward up to the left-hand spur and I'm back near the tractor.
No straight lines in nature.
Roger that, roger that.
There's nothing orange either.
And I think the one down, whoever was down there is gone, because they've all fucked off and they were all standing
there. Same on the left flank where there's about three of them, they're now just strolling through. So we need to pop down to the road and just stop them crossing.
We need to be careful we don't overextend, get baseline, stop them from going.
Well, there it all is over there.
It's all kicking off over that side and they're pushing on that.
All right, Nick. Right.
Do you want me to put a vehicle up on that?
Just put that working?
Yeah.
Just get the vehicle, move
fine.
Down.
Matt, get on the fucking shit out of
it, mate. Let's just fucking deal with that. It's running all right now.
Yeah, it should be. It's test for it. Put a few bursts in right up in the air or somewhere.
Yeah. No feet.
No feeding.
Yeah, there you go.
Keep making it.
Straight ahead.
Yeah, straight
just
ahead.
Literally just into the, probably three metres in.
Right. Is it fern moving down there? What, they're on firing. A lot of movement
down
there. Yeah,
that's wind though, mate.
Yeah, there's three man recce team?
Yeah.
Yeah, on my wagon, lads.
Yep.
The others hold here, yeah?
Yep.
If you're not on the recce team, hold here.
Rip, go, go. Are we doing the good? Team on the
wagon? Yeah,
no, don't stay here.
Right, you cross it here.
We can't shoot from there, can we? So that's cool.
Don't go by yourself. It's already
in the air. So tuck in then.
Okay, what we're going to do is we're going to deploy you via road to a better position.
Yep. Right.
And then you can get on task then.
Right.
Excellent. Okay, so stay in this. You got enough.
Yeah, we're good to go.
Yeah,
good for the day.
Okay.
Yeah. Matty, there are about five of them just extending through the woods. We caught them out on the crossroads and beat them off, but it's just open to them now.
Yeah, we've just got to decide now where we're going to deploy these. Do you want to have a quick look at the map?
Yeah.
See, we're obviously avoiding that area there, so we'll have to go round.
Yeah.
Let these guys know where you want to go.
We'll make all the driver stop.
Right.
Appreciate it. The track goes straight through to that Hound's Tooth, so that junction there, so it just zaps straight through to Black 3, so that route, Black 3, sorry, all the way down, you can go down there and across the Red 3 from there, there's a track at the bottom.
Yeah.
So.
Oh,
and
there's really a good place to turn vehicles there as well.
Yeah, it's big with the cliffs.
6-3, yeah. This is zero, yeah. Reading you, Lima Charlie, over.
Should we, Mikey? Hello? Should we get...
Sabre 4, this is zero, message.
Tim and Matty on there to go down the road.
Yeah, listen mate, there's an enemy vehicle moving around. Can you move and make a set up a quick VCP in and around Red 3, over.
This could be us here, but...
Well, you got the 50 cars.
Can you set up a VCP in the vicinity of Red 3, over.
They always do, mate.
Yeah, roger that. On route.
Yeah, roger. Be advised, there is an enemy wagon rolling around, over.
Yeah, they need to set up a VCP.
Yeah, they're on.
Well, all I'm going to do is swing it around in a big circle, if you see what I mean. So if anything comes up there, I'll put it around in a big circle and start heading towards it.
Let's go with the wagon.
Oh, I just need a beer.
Something, we're going to move off?
Yeah, remount. Yeah, roger.
Yeah mate, watch your rear. George, Matt. Yeah mate, that you've got a friendly patrol coming down in the direction that we said. Roger so far. I'll have a look, yeah? Roll behind me! Yeah, go.
Yeah, we're good.
Have you?
Somebody gave me, I've got half a bit of
barrel. Absolutely disgusting.
Picked up an additional 5 packs. We now have 9 in total.
Down to yeah, so the blue Landy, which has got George, has definitely moved up into the black route. We don't know where. We came down around the red MSR and we didn't see it. So it's up in those black routes somewhere, mate.
They've gone to here, they're there.
No, so it's gone via black 1 or black 2.
Right.
They've moved via black 1 or black 2 and they're in a blue vehicle.
We're going along red, yeah?
Down there.
Yeah. We're better off this way, we can hit round.
cricket match for that.
What?
Pace mask on.
Feet on the floor.
You got a nanny! Yeah, get him down here! Willie, you got more taps?
Got a medic over here, guys.
I've got a hero medic, I'm us now.
What? Guns up, boy! Dead man's quick, but you run across.
Hey, Icon. Are you alive?
Lay down, Mitch.
Bleeding out.
Turn your face to me.
Lads, these guys need searching now.
You're supposed to be, yeah.
Yes, please. All right, folks. Yeah, mate, someone on me, hey! Someone on me! Come to me, mate.
Just hold that.
So we're currently between Red 3 and Red 4. The enemies are on the blue line there.
Oh, hang on, no, 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 hang on. Wait.
Where's the guys that are with you?
Still there.
You should still be on the 10 truck.
Yeah.
Yeah, with the other pool set. Right. Who do you want to lift?
Dunk.
What?
Do you want to lift Dunk?
Well, are they all bled out?
Mate, no, you've got lift anyone.
Has
lift
Dunk got a medic?
Yeah, Dunk's been medic.
Mate, if you're going to lift anyone, lift Dazza.
No, they're done.
They're dead.
They're all bled out, mate. But I got Dazza's name and he had a Asda receipt on him with a bag for life, so he's got a new burger, mate.
Mate, they've all got names.
Yeah, we got all of that.
A little bit faster.
Should we do this nicely?
We can do this nicely, or we can do this bag overhead and sort of drag it.
Put your hands on your fucking head.
Another try, mate. Where are you going?
Hey, Will, George.
Emma, this is Nick. Do you read me over?
Roger, Nick,
yeah, what, Roger, we have George secure. We have all call signs on our side up and ready. We also have one captive who was the driver of the vehicle.
Don't do that again.
Emma, did you copy that, mate?
Roger, Nick, get everyone back to...
Yeah, roger that. So we need to get as many on the wagon as possible, and then everybody else is going to have to walk, unfortunately. Yeah, I'll come back and pick up the ones, the walkers. So let's work out what we can get on, and then let's get going.
I shouldn't let him go off his own.
No. In all fairness, we would have done that to George, though.
No, he wouldn't. He just wouldn't have let him go.
Are you right? Actually, he wouldn't let him go off his own because he'd be tied to a tree.
Yeah, we would have given him that. We would have given him that.
Yeah, great thing. Knocking's fine. It's when you hear a snap or a tin. Stop. Yeah, mate, send a message. Our depot. Then we're going to move out to go get Dunk. And then if necessary, we could come and find you and get you out the crap. Welcome to our boat.
Swing left, and then you hook it right around that tree.
Yeah. That's dumb.
No,
that's
dumb.
That one.
Yeah.
Well, I know where it is
now.
You guys okay?
Yeah,
yeah.
Good.
Yeah, happy, yeah? Your depot okay in so far?
Yeah.
We took our two call signs.
Just
yeah.
Nice.
Yeah, it was alright, yeah. It was a good day to die.
Yeah.
Which is what happened in the end anyway.
It was like
I'd read a book and then I lived it. Thank you.
You look like Noah.
I've met them. They took me because I was being tetchy as fuck and they were all a bit.
They should have lifted me.
They released me and I came down the hills. Like a what?
The staff.
The staff of power.
Good man.
If the tea lands on, you can always pop your boy in the bag.
Yeah, I'll do that.
Are we still waiting on Dunk to come back?
Yeah.
What's the mate day?
That was an awesome ambush.
Good that one. We got everybody in here.
But we're really sucked as I went down. It's all loose grass. And I slid down to twice.
Right, first of all, we started, we moved across, down. Nothing there that we found of any sort of enemy activity. Moved across, linked up with Team Dunk. At this point here, we linked up with Team Dunk. We had an ID. We had an ID set up, but we forgot that idea. We then made our way right round and came down this road here, cutting close to the edge. With the Dutch team, we engaged two technicals on the sort of shale road, you know, with the cliff overhang. Yeah, we engaged two technicals on the on this road here. They bugged out and we continued up to this point here. We then got eyes on an enemy sort of camp in this location here. And the original vehicles that we'd engaged were all parked along this road. There were three vehicles.
Far right road.
Yeah. Far right road.
Yeah, a little
bit further. Yeah. There, yeah. And they had an encampment around here.
So they lived it looking like it's.
Yeah, they had bashers up, they had camps, everything. That was. We had eyes on them, and then one of them was going to take a dump and he spotted us, so we bugged out.
No, like I said, I'm quite happy to kill what I'm prepared to eat. And I'm not prepared to eat humans, therefore.
Has a decision been made in regards to the location of the new depot? Have we made it?
We're actually talking of putting it in that area, but lower down.
Okay.
But we think that's probably just too close.
We could use a perimeter road coming behind.
Yeah. If you reckon that's something we can do.
It's a possibility.
I mean, worst comes, they'll see you going past. If you just drive, you know, they're not going to think you're going for them anyway. We could possibly use it as an opportunity to drop off a team while you're driving past to do an observation on that position.
Around the perimeter and come up behind. Is Dunk here?
Where's Dunk? Is he?
Dunk!
The other thing we want to do is to see if we can get eyes on this. And that might involve a bit more sneaky beaky.
If we drive down to the other side of the hill, they can then tap the stuff across, can't they?
Yeah, that's
true. We've got the off secure. They can tap it over the hill.
Well, if your team takes control, if you guys deal with the depot, Darren's team deals with trying to get eyes on that position.
I'm just taking
volunteers. Good job.
So yeah, and see if we can get ideas on what their location is. Okay. If they are based there, then we'll put the force together. We'll work out a plan, and we will smash them if they're based in that location. The other thing is, for regards to conducting ourselves during the evening, what we're looking to do is to spread ourselves with the other teams and base ourselves at the other depots. So if we're setting that depot up, we can base a team there. We'll leave the Wolf Pack holding this one, and that leaves this one really, doesn't it?
Yeah, that's seen them have been there all day, haven't they?
Well, they've been in and out on it. They're okay with being based there, and we can put a team there as well. It's the most, we can reinforce that position. So I would say this one and this one. I'm open to suggestions on it, but I'd say these are the two ones that we can we can enforce. And what we'll have is white light. We'll have it secured because we'll need white light to be able to see it. But if they come to us, we can we'll give them hell if they do.
Red 6, that's what, if that's where the camp is.
You want a bumper?
Yeah, later when it gets dark.
Can you run out and walk it?
Yeah. Okay, I think
coming
so.
Coming in. Friendly.
Probably putting foot call signs out and then pick them up from the wagons later on. Or...
What's that, mate?
Sounds good.
Let them man this.
You terminate them.
Yeah, they can go white light as much as they want. Mm.
I mean all the way, like.
Yeah.
Just cut through on there's you, a new road that links these two. It kind of goes through the boundary of the wood yard.
Yeah, sure.
And then we came down through here, spoke to a civvy who was in there.
Civvy?
Yeah. Okay. He sort of waved us down, so we stopped and said hello to be polite.
And what did he say?
And he was like,
if you go up that way,
he told us where all the roads were.
That's helpful, civvy.
Yeah. It is possible, but rough.
Yeah. He said this road's closed. We didn't go down it to check, but it's potentially shut. And then we managed to wrangle all the way up there, and it is rough as fuck. You wouldn't get most stuff up there because it's quite tight. The pickup would just squeak through.
Okay.
Snatch because of gradient, or
I think so.
Yeah.
Some of it was quite steep, and some where there's trees sort of leaning in.
Radio the guys.
And then we came back along here, and our assumption is that there's a track that links these two.
Yeah.
Again, the civvy said there was, and we sort of saw it.
I think there is a track that goes right around the border.
Yeah. And Blue Landy was parked up there.
Yeah.
And there was evidence of lots of traffic up and down all these roads.
This is, we got a ping, the recce teams have pinged a large camp here.
Yeah.
So we're going to hit that after last light.
An easily drivable road linking those across that side. It carried on down there but looked way too sketchy for my little pickup.
Right.
We went down here and it's completely blocked.
We couldn't really get into any of this. Okay.
So that's kind of the only area we haven't really checked.
Right.
Here.
We've got good comms. Yeah.
So we could
go out in a three-vehicle convoy.
Six quad. Two and that, six, three were up in this area.
Yeah, so we know 6-1 is.
They're up in there. We didn't see them, but once we were up in...
I'd say just go quad on that.
We had really clear comms.
But we could spread out a little bit, mate.
Five,
and then we've got
one,
an
not
escape
route.
Sure.
Yeah. 5-1 was pinging
the guys out a little bit.
One of the six golfers, I'm not sure which one.
Four guys in there. And then the rest in there.
Mikey? Your location yet?
They just want a mobile beach and a mobile four. Okay.
Alright,
that's it.
Cool.
Just get them to jump in, man.
What's that?
Get these four to jump in, man.
Yeah.
Shove your lads in there and then you've got this.
But we've got to wait, because once we leave, we've not got comms to them. We're on
Matt, I liaise with you.
Yeah.
Through chat.
him in the vehicle.
Yeah,
all right,
he loaded in.
Okay. Literally two vehicles and virtually all of them.
Can we get everyone from clearing around this vehicle? I'd like to put it back.
Guys,
up.
Don't move away from the vehicle!
Yeah. I just want to know what you guys want to do. They are just there, but they could have bugged out. We're all back in play now.
Yes.
Do you want to, on force, make a play for them and fight, or would you rather let them go about their business and then us reallocate ourselves
normally,
around that
area? Fight. But they've got all three vehicles, we're technical as well.
Yeah.
We ain't got a chance of...
We probably haven't, but we have got that as well.
Are they with us? Well, they're taking them back.
And you haven't even thought of Ethan being here, have you? Do you know what I mean?
You know what I mean?
He's on there. Mounted only badger.
So enemy vehicle approaching.
We're golden.
We've lost our choice.
Mate, you got your tackle on you, with you?
Yeah.
You want to pop one of them out?
Can I tag him?
Yeah, tag him.
Go! Good, Neil. Come on. Good,
anything sharp, like no damage, no callbacks.
So, mate,
he gets pictured first
before he turns around and says he's bled out.
He's just gone.
Oh, that's cool,
I'll let you go.
You'll have another.
I just want to
reach it out. Oh, that's a nice bit. He's pretty, isn't he?
Yeah.
He's got a lovely smile.
Ooh. That's your blower.
Good times never seem so good. I'm inclined to believe in
that. I fucking love this guy.
I need to go and fucking see them as well.
What, are they dead?
Yeah, they're dead as well.
Let's do that. You need to go search these guys out.
Yeah, fuck face. Look happy.
Oh, what did he say? He told us. He was standing there when he told us. So, can you
like... Matt, nothing on the map that I could see.
Okay, mate.
Should we go back?
Give that to Mikey when we get back.
Mikey back at base?
Yeah.
Should we go out then? Should we fuck off?
Shall we? Right. Oh.
Stirred the hornet's nest. Do you want to just keep poking it?
Yeah.
I know where they are. We saw two of their heads.
If you've found any of their transit camps at all,
we haven't found them, but we know when HVI's got in, got dicked, and then we observe them walking past the house.
Yeah, as I walked down, right. Their vehicles. And then all the vehicles stacked up there.
And then when we got attacked, they all came up the path from that way.
From that way.
Definitely.
So,
have killed.
Okay. Remind me that we'll listen to that. I'm just being
fucking too.
You drop down to red 3.
Yeah.
And then cut across.
That's what we've done last time.
And go up again.
Yeah, on the edge. Yeah. Stay in that side. But I want you to check anything by a track within 20 metres of that track. We need to be checking it.
Yeah. There was a guy in those bushes. He's like, don't shoot him, because where is he in the bush lot? What happened away?
It's like really back that pickup truck going on.
Oh, there's a tank compared to the pickup truck.
The holly bushes right to my face.
Seems to be a second one, do you know what I mean?
Yeah, I'll tell you where it is, mate. I came down here on the quad earlier. I went up here. It's actually further along. We're only just here, yeah.
Yeah, that's where I think we are.
No, we're not there, we're here. We're on 6, we're on black 6.
Black 6 here?
Mm.
Yeah, I don't think we are, mate. I think we're either here or here now. But that's where we've got to go. Will, go with Darren.
Yeah, sir, mate.
Yes. Yeah,
found a truck on the transit camps that grid had found the deer.
Well, we think, yeah, we think it's ran down through the bracken, ran straight into the net. Its head's gone through the net because it's really quite quick, so it spooked it and it snapped it. The way its neck was, it looks like it snapped its neck. Because it's gone through it at some power, and we'll have to cut the wire to get it out. Break down there. Yeah. Break down. Scan, and you'll see the heat signature.
Same, yeah.
Yeah?
Mm-hmm. Unless that's friendlies. Let me double check. Right, so the plan this morning then is to essentially put in a blocking force with VCPs and start putting the squeeze on them, okay? By containing them into that area, we've already sort of succeeded. We've taken out a lot of their command and control, so we don't need to worry about that too much. It's more just a case of containment security now, okay? So what we're gonna do, like I said, is put in some VCPs. The VCPs will be at this junction here, one on here, and one on here. So they're all gonna be in a line, essentially, like that, okay? So all within the same grid square, like that, okay? from there, deploy people on foot to put the squeeze on at the border, okay? To probe their defenses around red 3 and red 4. To see if we can get into blue territory. Phase one then is to get this vehicle in place. It would be actually this vehicle here, the command vehicle, in place here on the high ground, and then we get decent comms. Okay, we'll do that by a concerted push with everyone we've got on foot up to secure that T-unit section there, with this rolling up into port behind, as well as the Wolf. Once we get to there and it's secure, the Wolf will roar down to here. So then we'll have those two locked down.
I'd get
up. Following it,
no? No, because I'm going to zip off, so I can't go slow on that.
Where's the rest of your guys, mate?
Yeah. Okay, let's push, guys. Push now.
Right,
I've got a pin. I've got a pin. 5-1. Move right now. Get moving! Three or four around there, mate. Second
Thank you.
Please don't.
Matt, use this berm. Use this berm and hold a line.
Dad, where are they?
I got him. I got him, mate. Who's
dead?
I don't know if there's anyone else up there, though. Yeah, we're in contact in this position here.
Yeah, roger, mate. We're on the move now to Red 3, Red 4.
Red 3, Red 4.
We'll message you in a bit, yeah?
Emmett, Johnny.
Go ahead, Johnny.
Hey mate, do you want us to come down and support you guys, or should we keep pushing up? We're on the way up to Red 5.
Yeah, I just want to keep bumping towards Red 5 on target there. I'll just liaise with Matt B. Out to you. Matt B.
Stay on
task.
Yeah,
Emmett, Matt, I'm just behind you, mate.
Yeah, Johnny wants to know, do you want the Sabre 4 to keep bumping on towards Red 5, over.
Mate, it might be worth if we can spare them elsewhere, get them to come up, park up next to our vehicles and move up with us.
Yeah, roger that.
So Johnny, let him know we're on foot but in a position to help him out.
See Johnny, message.
So mate.
Mate, if you want to bring your wagon down to Red 4, and then push onto the house on foot and support us, over.
We're on foot, mate, but we are in a position to support you.
Alright, roger. Yeah, Matt, this is it.
Mikey, George. Yeah, we're here with you, Mike.
Matt, hold there.
We got the Ranger pushing up to Red 5. They've been quiet for a while now.
Right, okay. Sabre 5, yeah.
And we've come down to support you.
Okay, cool. Well, if you push up the track, we'll push down low. We'll squeeze.
Yeah, roger, roger.
Right. We're pushing low. Trying to see them going high up the road. So we... Yeah, still going down there, yeah. Nick. Right, let me just pop this tank around now.
How far in you pushing?
Just see how far we can squeeze, mate.
Where's the other call signs? We got call signs back there?
Or is everyone... few. Everyone's starting to push that way.
Right.
So you'd be rear. But if they're behind us, you're also the front.
for.
Hey, Johnny, liaison Mikey, over.
What you got?
We haven't got a team to flank
on,
which we should have done before you
got
left.
Right, so we need to go back and secure the women.
Yeah, roger that. So we'll come back to you.
I think we'd be better off kind of reorging here, getting a baseline in so that we can then start moving out. But I think if we just keep pushing, we're going to overextend and we're going to lose the momentum.
Well, to be honest, let's stay here. Send Johnny to not back, so a bit of caution.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah, Matt, we're gonna stay here because we're a four man, and we're gonna send Johnny's call sign back to you because they're a much bigger call sign, mate.
Roger that. Then you organise teams that are on your left flank, because they seem to be pushing out and up the hill as well. She's gonna leave big gaps.
Yeah, roger that. Do you want to raise Johnny?
Yeah.
Right. Apparently, Emmett said we've got Bravos moving around the top. There was a team of four that was shot out here. Obviously, they've gone back to regen, which means they're going to be coming around here as well and trying to come back down. I have briefed them to watch the rear, but who knows?
There was two bodies further down.
Yeah, they've gone. They've got a flanking now.
They're down there, but...
Well, let's see the same.
Dave.
Yeah. They're with the wagon, aren't
they? Sabre 5, message.
See, moving here, we've got no friendly call signs advanced of you, have we?
There we go.
Hit! Put base of fire down, Trig!
Johnny, keep your head down!
Yeah. Trig, put your head down, mate.
Got him.
Can you see him or not?
Coming across, Matty, aye?
Yeah, go.
Yeah, I need your stoner, mate.
No, to the right, I think.
Emmett, get your gun!
Jack.
Get your gun!
Trick! You see the fall of shot of the gym tree? But I think it's to the right of that. Jack, in there.
They're a fair bit back, aren't they?
Yeah, much further back than the first fall.
Danny, that's left of you.
Contact left, yeah?
And it! Tag force, motherfuckers!
Stop!
Tag force, motherfuckers!
Get Steve from there.
He doesn't have a sight on it. Yeah, of course I do.
And it had flicked it at the last minute.
Yes, that's what I got.
Okay then guys, so we are operating as Special Operations Task Force Chad this weekend. Our main objective was to secure the Maibo border crossing, which runs from where that wagon is there up until the edge of the site up there, as you know. We also had a few secondary objectives, which was essentially to take out the command and control network and capture some HVIs, which I have some of. Raise your hand if it's you. Stephanie Badger Beed. Yeah. Patrick Boss. Yeah. Krukesh Dali.
You right?
Is that you? Yeah.
Abu Faria.
Cool. Eric Imani. Emin Manhamet. And Yannick Cisse. Cool, there we go. So that's who we managed to take out this weekend, which is good. Not for dinner, but actually kill him.
Same thing.
Yeah. So as far as the running of the border operations, we don't really know how we did. We found a few transit camps and things like that. We managed to find your command and control camp as well. I think we intercepted a few shipments, but as far as I know, I don't really know what the status was. You'd be able to give us more information on that. But secondary objectives were good. We did a lot of security patrols. The securing of the border today was especially good. The movement this morning, everyone did a really good job to get up and get down here. So well done, guys. I'll pass you over to Dom, but everyone who was working with us this weekend, appreciate it. Good hard work, nice one. Nice one, guys. Cheers.
From our perspective, we have multiple depots working for the KOA and AS elements that were spread in Chad, and with some that we've set up also in Car, with regular deliveries being made between the two, between the different locations. We had one we recently set up at towards the beginning of the operation, which unfortunately you guys seem to be harbouring around as well, which led to quite a fierce bit of firefighting for the first half of the game, which I have to say was pretty awesome, guys. But after realizing it was not practical to maintain that depot, we decided to collapse it and relocate it to a new position, after sending teams to scout out and decide where the best place would be for that to happen. Regular border crossings were made, and regular communication was made between those depots, between the various guys who were assigned to task and look after it. As the day progressed, we did find it harder and harder to make it past your forces as you gained a better understanding of the site and the areas that we were also using. I think that's everything from that.
Cool, yeah.
I've got to just say from perspective of our side, some brilliant firefights this weekend, guys. Just really good sportsmanship all around. In regards to the teams we've had, a lot of you guys I haven't worked with before. You stepped up. It's a huge site, and you know, even doing the smallest tasks required quite a bit of commitment. So thanks for that, guys, and I hope to see you guys again.
Cool.